Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the next question. Okay, so this question belongs to GATE CSC 2009. The question is, given the following state table of a finite state machine with two states A and B. So let me draw those states. Okay, one input and one output. Okay, if the initial states are 0, 0, what is the minimum length of an input string which will take the machine to state 0, 1 with output 1? Okay, so we are required to start at 0, 0 guys. Okay, so at 0, 0 we need to start. So there are two situations here, right? Yes. Okay, so we need to start at 0, 0 and we need to end at a point where 0, 1 and 1 the output. Okay, so you should end up at 0, 1 and 1 is the question, right? Yes. Okay, so let us start analyzing or thinking about this. Okay, yes. So the best case to end is 0, 1 and 1, right? So 0, 1 and 1 is here. 0, 1 and 1. So is it anywhere else, guys? I think no, right? Yes. Okay, so you need to end up with this. So how you can end up with this, guys? So the best way is to do trial and error method, right? I think that will be the best approach, right? Yes. So for easy understanding, let me give some numbers for these stages, guys. Or shall we do it directly? Okay, so let us do it directly. What is there in that, right? Yes. So from 0, 0 on input 0, you will go to 0, 0 with input 1. Means you will come here, right? Yes. So let us start drawing it so that will be a bit clear, guys. So from 0, 0, it's visible, right? So from 0, 0, with the input 0, okay, with the input 0, you will move to 0, 0 with the input 1. Okay, so this whole part is one state, guys, to be clear. Okay, so from this stage, you will be moving on to the next stage. So instead of these circles, I'll be writing them directly, guys. So you will be coming till here, right? So from here, you came here. That is 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. Okay, so this state is this state only and this state 0, 1, 0. So let's search for 0, 1, 0. So it is here 0, 1, 0, right? Yes. So from 0, 1, 0, okay, you can go to, so is there anywhere other 0, 1, 0 also, guys? So let us check. 0, 1, 0 is here, so it is nowhere else, right? Okay, so from 0, 1, 0 you can go to 1, 0, 0. Okay, so from 1, 0, 0, okay, so where is 1, 0, 0? So 1, 0, 0 is here, and is there it anywhere else? So let us check, is there it anywhere else? So 1, 0, 0, right? Okay, so from 1, 0, 0, okay, so 1, 0, 0 is nowhere else, right? So there are no repetitions here. Okay, so from 1, 0, 0, okay, you will go to 0, 1, 0. Okay, from 0, 1, 0, where you can go again? Okay, so again you are coming into a loop. See here, 0, 1, 0 and 0, 1, 0. Okay, so this is an infinite loop, so we should not pass through this thing, right? Yes. Okay, so now we got an idea, right? Yes. So let us continue with some other format. Okay, so I think rather than solving in this chain manner, so let us draw the diagram itself, guys. I think if we draw the diagram, it will be a bit more easy, right? Yes. So what are the different states here, guys? We are having 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, right? So there are total 4 cases. Okay. So the first case is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Okay. So are the outputs fixed, guys? So at 0, 0, we have 0. At 0, 0, we have 1. Okay. So these outputs are also varying, like they are changing, right? Yes. Okay, so anyway, let us start drawing the diagram so that as we go, we will be understanding how we can modify it and make it easy. So from 0, 0, okay, so from 0, 0, we are with input 0, okay, we will go to 0, 0 with output 1. So basically assume that inside only we will write outputs, guys. So output 1 is there if you give input 0, right? So you will be in the same state, okay? So this step is done indirectly, the whole step, okay? Now moving on, from 0, 1, okay, with input 0, okay, you will move to 1, 0. Okay, so from here, if you give input 0, you will move to 1, 0, and the output is 0. So you can write inside, right? Yes, so this part is also done. 1, 0, 0. Yes, okay. Similarly, from 1, 0, okay, so with the input 0, you will move to 0, 1. Okay, so this is a reverse process, right? So with the 0, and the output is also 0. So this is also done. Next, moving on to the next case, that is 1, 1, 0. 1, 1 with 0, you will move to 1, 0. So means with this with 0, you will move to 0, and the input, the output is 0 there. Done. So now moving on to the next case, that is 0, 0 with input 1. Okay, you will move to 0, 1. So you will move to 0, 1 with input 1. Okay, and the output is 0. So this step is also done. 0, 1. Okay, so from 0, 1. Okay, so from 0, 1. Okay, from 0, 1 with the input 1, you will move to 0, 0. Okay, so you will come back to 0, 0 and the output is 1. Okay, so that's perfectly matching. So the last two steps are from 1, 0, 1, 0 with the output 1. Okay, so with the output 1, we will move to 0, 1 with output 1. Okay, so 0, 1 is there with both outputs, right? Okay, so 0, 1 with 1. Okay, so I'll be drawing in between, guys. Okay, so 1, 0 with the input 1, we are moving to 0, 1 with the input 1. Nice. So from 1, 1, okay, so from 1, 1 with the input 1, okay, so from 1, 1, okay, with the input 1, we are going to 0, 0 with output 1. So this is the complete diagram, right? Okay, so if you observe carefully, so we did not fill this particular part, right? So is it not fillable, guys? So from 0, 1, where we can go? So 0, 1 is here. Similarly, 0, 1 is here. So from 0, 1 with input 0, you can go to 1, 0. So basically this is the reverse process. Similarly, from 0, 1, okay, from 0, 1 with input 0, you can go to 0, 0. With input 1, you can go to 0, 0, right? Yes. So now let us go through the question again. So now we have drawn the state diagram, right? Yes. So now we need to start at 1, 0, 0. Okay. So if we start at 0, 0 and we should end up with 0, 1, 0. So you should start at 0, 0 and you should end up with 0, 1 and the output should be 1. Got it? Yes. So now please concentrate for a minute, guys. Okay. So observe carefully. Okay, so the output should be 1. So if you observe carefully, so from 0, 0 with input 1, you can come to 0, 1, right? So with input 1, you can come to 0, 1. Okay, from 0, 1, you can go to 1, 0 with input 0. So now you are here. From here, you can go to 1, you can go to 1, 0, 1 with the help of 1. Okay, so with the string 1, 0, 1, we have successfully reached to the center part, right? So that is 0, 1. Output 1, right? Yes. So the minimum string which we require is a 3. So this is a quite a bit easy question only, but it will take some time, guys, because drawing this diagram in the examination is a bit complex, because even while drawing, I was a bit confused. Like every moment it's a bit confusion, right? Yes. So with the final conclusion, you can say A is the correct answer. It's a quite easy question only. The only thing is drawing the diagram carefully is really important, and please avoid these type of methods, guys, like thinking that you can solve it directly with the observing the table. So that's a bit complex, guys. Okay. Yes. So I hope everyone got a clear idea with respect to this question. So in the next lecture, let us continue with the next question. Okay. Yes. Thank you. Thanks for watching.
Like, share, and subscribe for more awesome videos like this. Thank you.